Now I will tell about the articles. I will show the articles which are required for the physical examination. First, in the picture, it is you are seeing a tongue depressor. This is a steel tongue depressor made up of steel. The tongue depressor is made up of steel. Now the next, it is also a type of spatula, tongue spatula or tongue depressor. With this you can visualize the oral cavity properly. And the buccal mucosa, you can see the buccal, examine the buccal mucosa. Then next, this is Sims speculum, Sims vaginal speculum. It is an instrument, purpose is to examine the vagina of a female patient. Then next, see carefully, because these all instruments will be asked in the examination, can be asked in any form of examination. This one is a nasal speculum. Nasal speculum is used for examining the nose, examining the nares. This is also a type of nasal speculum. This is nasal speculum made up of steel. Now next, this one is proctoscope. Proctoscope is an instrument which is used for the examination of anus and rectum. So you can see the parts of the proctoscope. The one is called as the obturator and the outer one is called as the proctoscope sheath. So proctoscope, the use of proctoscope is to examine the rectum. This is also the diagram of proctoscope. This is stethoscope. Most important if you are auscultating a particular organ or organ system. Auscultating means we are listening to the body sounds with the help of an instrument which is called as stethoscope. Please see the parts of the stethoscope. Ear pieces, the total, it is called as headset, ear tubes, the tubings are there, stem, the bell, the chest piece. One is the bell, another one is the chest piece, which is kept against the, either on the chest or on the abdomen to hear the sounds. So these are the parts of stethoscope. Next is BP instrument. BP instrument is also called as sphygmomanometer. Now sphygmomanometer is of two type. One is aneroid, another one is mercury. So here I will first show the aneroid sphygmomanometer. Here the aneroid, it is also labeled. You can see the diagram with labels, the tubings, the inflation bulb, the air release valve, then the hose or the tube connectors, the cuff. So this is a aneroid sphygmomanometer, aneroid manometer gauge, which shows the reading. Then next is the mercury sphygmomanometer. So mercury sphygmomanometer, mercury will be the column for measuring the blood pressure. So mercury is kept, the mercury column will rise when we are inflating the bulb. So these are the parts of mercury sphygmomanometer. The next instrument which is used, equipment which is used for physical examination is a simple tape measure. It is used to measure the circumference, the skull circumference, abdominal circumference, mid-arm circumference. mid-arm circumference is used to measure the nutrition value, nutrition level of especially for a child. Then skull circumference is used for the measurement in newborn, in a small child. Then abdominal girth is also measured. The growth of the uterus is measured with the help of this tape measure. Then next is, this is pharyngeal retractor. Retract means we, by retracting a particular instrument, we will be able to visualize properly a particular cavity. So this retractor will help in the visualization of pharynx. So this is pharyngeal retractor. Then next is otoscope. Otoscope means, scope is a type of equipment which uses light to see the organs, to see the parts, body parts. So otto is related to ear, scope, that means that this instrument will use light to see the ear, the pinna, ear, till the eardrum we will be able to examine. So this is otoscope. This is ophthalmoscope. This instrument also requires light. Scope means instrument which will use telescope, which uses a light source, and ophthalmoscope is also used to visualize the fundus or the retina. The next, it is laryngoscope. This instrument also uses light. These are the different size of blade. One is for the small child, then adults. There are different blades, and this is used for the visualization of larynx. Especially it is used for endotracheal intubation. That means when the patient will be connected to the mechanical ventilator for artificial ventilation, one tube will be inserted, that is called as endotracheal tube. During that time, laryngoscope is required to see the larynx. Next, it is tuning fork. So tuning fork, you see the parts of a tuning fork. This one is stem, prongs. Stem and prongs, these are two parts, and this is used for, it is for examining the ear, actually function of ear. The Weber test and Rini test, these are two tests which are performed with the help of this tuning fork to find out whether the person is having conductive hearing loss or the sensory hearing loss. So this is also a tuning fork. Stem, the prong, and this is the foot piece. The next is flashlight or a torch. It is also required in the physical examination. The next is the percussion hammer. Percussion hammer is also used for assessing the reflexes, knee reflex, Achilles reflex. To test the reflexes, percussion hammer is used. These are some safety pins. These are used in the neurological examination to assess pain sensation, whether patient, a client feels pain or not. Then there are certain specimen containers that after examination, if you need to collect specimen, some specimen containers are also present. Then gloves are present. Sometimes gloves are also required. Cotton wools are present. Hot water, cold water are used. These are all used for neurological examination. So these are the articles, some of the articles which I have shown for neurological examination. For physical examination.